For Kanya Rashi people, this eclipse is happening in the 10th house. Now, Rahu has taken the form of Tamra, Tamra Murti, and he is bad there. So overall, this eclipse is not going to be that great for you. There will be a lot of career related problems for those people who are born in Kanya Rashi. Especially problems would be in the form of some sort of a conflict with other team members. Not your own team members, but other team members. There will be a lot of competitive spirit that is happening. There will be a lot of clashes that happen. These are going to be very common for you. The second thing that you would actually experience would be in the matters of property. So there would be a lot of property related issues that you might actually encounter. It could be that there is a damage to the property, so you end up, you know, going ahead and repairing it and restoring it, etc. Or it could also be in the form of, you know, if you have a land, for example, there could be some sort of an encroachment, or there could be temporary disturbance that happens within the property, and you will have to go and resolve all these things. Also, those people who are born in Kanya Rashi, especially the unmarried people, so they need to be a little cautious. There is a high chance that you might actually break up the relationships. So be careful there. If you are married, there will be frequent quarrels with the spouse. So if you are a female, you will be constantly quarreling with the husband. If you are a male, you will be constantly quarreling with the wife. Let's come to the remedial measures. So what are the remedial measures that you need to undertake? First, during the eclipse, there are two things that I want you to do. First, I want you to chant the Ganesha mantra. Do the japa of Ganesha mantra. The mantra is Om Gam Ganapataye Namah. Second, I want you to chant one of the two mantras that I am going to give now. The first one is Om Namo Narayanaya. And if you are chanting this, use a Tulsi Mala. Second one is Om Namah Shivaya. And if you are chanting this, use a Rudraksha Mala. Now chant this as many times as possible, but in multiples of 108. Use the mala to your advantage while counting. Once the eclipse is over, now this is an annular eclipse, which essentially means the effects are going to be there all the way for 3 months. Once this eclipse is over, here's what I want you to do. I want you to donate horse gram, black dal, and tur dal. Three things: horse gram, black dal, and tur dal. And I want you to donate this to the poor. Donate this as many times as possible. So the eclipse is going to be there for 3 months. So see how often you can donate this. You want to donate it daily, that's great. But whatever is your capacity, but if it's going to be difficult for you, you want to do it once in every 2 days, once in a week, once in every month, whatever may be comfortable for you, donate it. The minimum quantity that you need to donate would be a fistful. So donate a fistful of horse gram, a fistful of black dal, and a fistful of tur dal. In addition to that, I also recommend you recite Hanuman Chalisa every day. If it is very difficult for you to recite Hanuman Chalisa, at least whenever you are not able to recite, on those days when you are not able to recite, at least hear to it, listen to it.